Now it's time for the next lesson in Toolbox. So we've already laid our cabinets out in a plan view. Now it's time to continue with these shop drawings and get our elevations going. So open up that project and we'll get into this next lesson of training. So now our plan view looks pretty good. We can move on, get some elevation drawings going before we start adding these to our sheets. Just remember when you're drawing your 2D elevations to select your 3D walls. I'm just picking that reference point so we know that we're aligned with our plan view above. And before we start doing any work on detailing this elevation, let's get elevation B drawn. So we'll call this one elevation A and our adjacent wall being elevation B. Use our polar tracking line to make sure that's aligned with the floor from elevation A and let Toolbox draw those cabinets. Okay, so far so good. Now into elevation A. So first off, I want to point out that we have our text showing up above this window. Now that doesn't come in by default with this wall. That's something that I've already added as a 2D drawing token. So we'll save that for our next video and show you how we can add a 2D drawing token to a product or a room component in this situation, and also have it formula driven so it automatically updates for us. I'm going to get rid of these polylines here. We don't need those anymore. Okay, so I'm going to want to add some more dimensions here. I also want to go through maybe showing our sink. Now, a couple different ways that we can do that. Inside of the product, we have the option to add our countertop back. And when we do that, our countertop options tab opens with the appliance options calling out a sink. Now, that's great for drawing purposes. It'll show us the sink. But remember, if we add that to a product, it's going to also show up on a report. Now, even though this is a buyout product in the project, we still have that buyout report. And there's going to be an additional countertop on here because we already have that product 150 drawn, which is our buyout countertop. So just something to keep in mind. Yes, we get our 2D drawing, elevation, and plan view, but you also have that additional product included. I'm going to go back in there, turn it off, and we're just going to use some AutoCAD commands to annotate this drawing. Show the sink by adding a rectangle, maybe changing the properties, give it a dashed line so it looks hidden behind the doors. And we can do a multi-liter with text, calling out that we have some type of sink going on here. I'm going to just give it a description. And maybe if there was some description here that we wanted to add for the sink cabinet, this is a non-ADA sink, into location. All right, now one thing that I like to do when I add text over a microfilm product, you can double click to edit, right click, and give this a background mask. Use the background drawing color, and what it's done there is giving ourselves a border so we're blocking out anything that's behind the text. So you can update that window, do whatever you need to. Now moving on to this countertop, I wanted to point out how we have this dimension coming in. So some of our products have a 2D drawing token, an elevation drawing token for the dimension. Others use a global variable like our base cabinets, but the countertop works a little bit differently. It's actually controlled by our dimension above product under the product drawing setup. Currently set to 6 inches. I change that to 10 and redraw. And that's how we can change the location of that dimension. So that's one of the products that uses that product above drawing inside of our product drawing setup. So if you're wondering why I'm not using the redraw selected products and going through the prompts page instead to redraw some of these cabinets, it's just because I've counted up the clicks and it actually takes one more click to go through redraw selected products. So every click counts, just trying to be as efficient as possible. Now to show the cabinets on our adjacent wall, show the hatched return using our 2D drawing tools and selecting what side of the cabinet that we want to see. I've already went through and set it up with the correct values. Because we have that column, just make sure that we select that point there. And now we have our hatched return of our base cabinet. 22 7/8 coming out to the face of the door. If you wanted to draw a rectangle or something representing that door, you could do that. Quick dimension of the countertop. And let's do the same thing to our upper cabinet. And just a couple more dimensions to finish off this elevation. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Before we move on, there is one other thing. Let's change the finish label. So instead of it being this style, we're going to make it look more bold as we put it on our shop drawing. So to do that, we'd have to go into our global variables and change the text style of that finish label. Now, because there's so much other text using that annotative style, I don't want to modify that text style in AutoCAD. So I could just change it to a new one by selecting one of the styles in this list or maybe it's not even in this list and we need to add it. So to do that, we can go into our, which I don't remember exactly where it is. So why don't we go find a variable. This one is going to be called textile. There it is, textile options. Now scrolling down, these are all the different textile options that we can choose from in that pull down list. To add a new one, I'm going to sneak one in here right before none. Call this one MV underscore one. And make sure that we add a pipe symbol in between every textile. Hit OK. I'm going to refresh. And now under our finished label textile, you should see this new MV1 as an option. And there it is. And now into our AutoCAD textile manager, we can get there from our ribbon and the different textiles that we have inside of this drawing. There's our MV1, which I already had set up. The different fonts, you can change height, all the different options that you have in here. We're going to change the font style from regular to bold. Now redraw our 2D walls. Now we've got our new finished label textile showing up with a different font. Elevation B, we can do a similar thing here, just detailing it out with any kind of dimensions or other objects. Oh, that looks good. All I did there was add a few height dimensions and also a couple rectangles representing our countertop. I think the last thing that we'll do here, since we're not showing that corner filler, get our countertop dimensions. I'm going to just draw a simple rectangle to show that corner filler. I'm going to start it at 22 and an eighth away, because I know that's going to be the backside of our filler. Thickness and the height. I can just drag it up there and you can see how that 30 and a half is showing. So once I left click on my mouse, we have our new filler. Use our match properties to get it to the same color and be an AutoCAD hatch return, H for hatch, and show our hatched filler and countertop. So I don't know, maybe not exactly how you would show it, but at least we got something in there and it looks pretty good that we can send off, see if it's acceptable to our customer. All right, so that brings us to a good stopping point. We'll call this one done for now and we'll pick it back up in our next video. So until next time, keep practicing and we'll meet back here for some more training.